we are now compressing this spring to increase its length. This has been done by the help of this spring compressor. This has to be freely moved. After that, remove this top nut which we have already loosened. Take out this washer. Take out this bush. It should be like this only, otherwise it is going to create some noise into it. Remove this mount. So there is another rubber which sometimes gets stuck in the mount. This has to be placed like this. Remove this. Remove the washer, this pipe also from the shock absorber. Remove this entire spring now. Remove the bump stop. So this is the raw shock absorber. Now we are not going to use this original washer and its nut. These all things are been provided by ARC with the new shock absorber. So you don't require this to be fit on to the vehicle. So this is the shock absorber what we are providing for XUV500. We provide this washer along with this two nuts. One is a main nut, another is a check nut for extra security. This washer has got a groove inside that has to be placed accordingly. It has to be placed like this only while fitting, that I would be showing afterwards. So first of all, we need to fit this buffer onto this shock absorber. So while fitting, you have to put some grease on this inner surface and also on this part so that it glides onto the shaft. We have to fit this bump stop in this way. There would be slight resistance while fitting, but that is okay, that is a part of a fitment. You have to take care that it has been placed onto the piston of the shock absorber. Take care that these grooves are fitted onto the downside of the shock absorber like this. After that, take this bushing. This has to be, the cone part should be at the downside of the shock absorber while putting the downward bushing like this. Take the spring, put onto our shock absorber. While fitting, take care that the spring has been resting onto this part. This has to be checked, because otherwise it will create a noise while working. So that has to be taken care of. After this complete assembly, take the mount, fit onto it like this. So now here comes another factor which has to be taken into consideration, that now the cone has to be at upper side like this. Just press it, put on the old washer which you have removed from the old shock absorber, put the retaining nuts onto it. Now after tightening this retaining nut, we have supplied this another check nut which has to be bolted and tightened on the top of the main retaining nut. So now we are good to go to fit the shock absorber. After removing the spring compressor from the shock absorber, you can directly fit this shock absorber onto the vehicle. Thank you.